Good morning, children. Hope you are doing good at home. As I am having an exam, that is unit test, we will now see the revision for the unit test. For an English exam, we will see the unit test revision. So, before we get into the revision, we will see what is the question pattern. So, in question pattern, you will have three parts: part 1, part 2, part 3. Part 1 is reading comprehension, that is, you will be given a passage and receiving the passage, you will have to answer the questions. It contains 4 marks. For reading, you will get 4 marks. And grammar part, so you will be having all the subtopics inside this grammar part. So grammar part contains 14 marks. The next part, that is third part contains literature question and answers. That means synonyms, antonyms, writing words and question and answers, that is 7 marks. So reading 4 marks, grammar 14 marks, literature 7 marks. On the whole, you will have 25 marks for this unit test. And after this question pattern, just let's see what are the portions to be seen. Already we have told you the portion. Just let's see once again. First poem, that is Bless This My Words. And from prose, we have a great heroine. And from grammar part, we have singular and plural, phrases, homophones, present and past tense, conjunctions using so and that, which means combining sentences using so and that. So, from this poem and prose, you have to revise all the book back exercises also, and also you can have in the part 1 reading comprehension with this. Fine. Now we'll move to reading comprehension. For reading comprehension, you will get a passage like this. You'll be given a passage, not the exact passage, this is just for revision. You'll be given a passage, and by reading the passage, after understanding the passage, you'll have to answer few questions that is given in the question paper. So what you have to do is, you'll have to read the passage, understand the meaning of the passage, and then you'll have to answer the questions that follows the passage. We'll now see the example ones. Let me read this. Mithun likes to help his mom make cookies. Chocolate chip cookies are his favorite. His mom likes them too. He adds the chocolate chips. Then he stirs them in. He forms the pattern in the balls and places them on a baking sheet. His mom places the sheet into the oven. When they are in the oven, Mithun licks the last bits of batter in the bowl. He can hardly wait for the cookies. The baking is over in 30 minutes and now the cookies are hot and yummy to be served. Let me read once again. Mithun likes to help his mom make cookies. Chocolate chip cookies are his favorite. His mom likes them too. He adds the chocolate chips. Then he stirs them in. He forms the batter into balls and places them on a baking sheet. His mom places the sheet into the oven. When they are in the oven, Mithun licks the last bits of batter in the bowl. He can hardly wait for the cookies. The baking is over in 30 minutes and now the cookies are hot and yummy to be served. So, first read the passage, then understand the meaning of the passage. Who are the characters given here? Mithun and his mom. There are two characters in this passage, Mithun and his mom. So, Mithun wants to help his mom in making cookies. What are cookies? Cookies are biscuits. So, he wants to help his mom in making cookies. So, what does he do? He likes chocolate chip cookies the most and his mom also likes the same. So, chocolate chip cookies are the favorite of his mom as well as Mithun. So, they both like it. He adds the chocolate chips. So, what he does is, he adds the chocolate chips, then he stirs them in. After that, he forms the batter into the ball and places them on a baking sheet. So, he takes the baking sheet, he forms the batter and taking the batter into balls, small balls, and he places them on a baking sheet. And his mom places the sheet into the oven. So once he finished preparing baking sheet, he gives it to his mom and she places the sheet into the oven. And when they are in the oven, then they refers to the balls that are kept in the oven. So when they are in the oven, Mithun licks the last bits of batter in the bowl. He couldn't resist his interest. So he licks the last bits of batter in the bowl that he had already. He can hardly wait for the cookies. So he wants to eat the cookies now. He couldn't wait for till it is over cooking. So the baking is over in 30 minutes and now the cookies are hot and yummy to be served. So it takes 30 minutes for the cooking to be done. And after 30 minutes, the cookies are hot and yummy and they are ready to be served. So we have understood the passage now. Now there are few questions given. We will have to answer the questions that are given. Read the questions now. What kind of cookies are Mithun's favorite? The first question is, what kind of cookies are Mithun's favorite? Now come to the passage. What kind of cookies are his favorite? Chocolate chips cookies are his favorite. So we are writing the same sentence here. Try to bring answers from the question itself. So what kind of cookies are Mithun's favorite? What kind? We are adding chocolate chip cookies. So chocolate chip cookies, other things you are taking from the question itself. Are Mithun's favorite. Chocolate chip cookies are Mithun's favorite. The next question, where does he place the ball of batter? So what does he do? He forms the batter into balls and places them on a baking sheet. So we have got the answer in this line and we have to write, he places the balls of batter on a baking sheet. So we take the answer from here and we write here. Where does he place the balls of batter? He places the balls of batter on a baking sheet. The next question, what does his mom do with the baking sheet? So once the baking sheets are over, what does his mom do? His mom places the sheet into the oven. So we write this answer here. His mom places the baking sheet into the oven. The last question, how long does it take to bake the cookies? How long does it take, Priya? The baking is over in 30 minutes and now the cookies are hot and ready to be served. So how many minutes it takes? It takes 30 minutes. So we are writing here, it takes 30 minutes. It takes about 30 minutes to bake the cookies. That's all. So the passage will be given. You'll have to read the passage, understand the passage and answer the questions. Just depending the answers which is given here. Okay children, we'll move on to the next part. So in our grammar part, we'll start with homophones. Homophones, already we have had a class for homophones. This we'll see for revision. What's homophone? Homophone is a word that's spelled different and means different but pronounced the same. Homophone is a word that is spelled different and means different but pronounced the same. See for examples, new. The word spells different, the pronounce is same and the meaning is also different. New. And here, years. When you see new, what's the meaning of first new? K-N-E-W, that is agreeing something that we know. And this new is brand new. And when you come here, years means it is 12 months consists 1 year. So when it goes more than 1 year, we will say years. And the next years is E-A-R-S is part of our body, years. The tool for hearing. So new, years. Both use different spelling but pronounces the same and differs in meaning. Here also spelling is different, meaning is same and pronunciation is same. Okay, let's see some examples here. Exercises. Fill in the blanks using the correct words from the box. Fill in the blanks using the correct words from the box. So you will be given the words in the box. The homophone words will be given in the box. You need to find out which word will be suitable for the sentence given. See the first one. Nithya had to dash for the bus. The words given here is big. The pronunciation is big but the spelling differs. W-A-I-T. The next one is W-E-G-H-T. W-E-I-G-H-T. So Nithya had to dash for the bus. Probably we do wait for the bus. So dash is W-A-I-T. Nithya had to wait for the bus. Next one, a dash of Turks was hiding in the woods. Troop, T-R-O-U-P-E and now the next word is P-R-O-O-P. Of course the answer is P-R-O-O-P. A troop of Turks was hiding in the woods. The next sentence, he laid dash to Chittur. C-H-R-C-E-S. The answer is S-E-I-G-E. Siege. He laid siege to Chittur. The next one, Mala then listened to her mother's advice. What's the spelling for advice here? A-D-V-I-C-E-R-A-D-V-I-S-E. The answer is A-D-V-I-C-E. So, Mala then listened to her mother's advice. Next one. There is a dash in the bucket. Only for the hole in the bucket, you do use H-O-L-E. This hole means the on the hole. So, W-H-O-L-E. So, there is a hole in the bucket. H-O-L-E. There is a hole in the bucket. Nitya had to wait for the bus. W-A-I-T. A troop of thugs was hiding in the woods. T-R-O-P. He laid siege to Chittu. S-E-R-G-E. Mala didn't listen to her mother's advice. A-D-V-I-C-E. There is a dash in the bucket. H-O-L-E. So with this, we are finishing the revision of homophones. Hope so you must have written all the exercises in your book bag and go through all these, complete this, get thorough. Next we'll move on to phrases. So we have completed as after homophones, we'll move on to phrases. All that we have seen phrases, you see here. Phrases, a group of words in a sentence without a subject and a verb. A group of words in a sentence without a subject and a verb. Can you see the examples? The sun rises in the east. So the phrases here is in the east. In the east. There is no subject. There is no verb. When you take phrase, it doesn't give proper sense. But it is a group of words. It is a group of words. It doesn't give sense. And there is no subject. There is no verb too. The sun rises in the east. So in the east will be the phrase here. The next one, the vehicle is parked near a tree. So leave this after the subject and verb. What is given? Near a tree. There is no subject and a verb here. And near a tree doesn't give full sense. And the vehicle is halted near a tree. Near a tree will be the phrase here. After this, when you go to the exercises of phrase, we'll do some exercises here. Like this, you'll be getting for your exams also. Fill in the blanks using the right phrase. Fill in the blanks using the right phrase. When you get right phrase, when you get for the exercises for phrases, you need to know the meaning of the phrase given. So, a bowl from the blue. For example, I am given only two here. A bowl from the blue and the next word is greenhorn. First, we will know the meaning of greenhorn and a bowl from the blue. What's the meaning of greenhorn? See here. Meaning of greenhorn is someone who is inexperienced. Someone who is inexperienced. Not enough experience. And the next word is a bowl from the blue. What's the meaning of bowl from the blue? An unexpected happening. Without expectation, something happens. So, an unexpected happening. So, by having these meanings, you are going to fill the sentences now. The dash who joined the softball team needs a lot of practice. The dash who joined the softball team needs a lot of practice. Of course, what's the meaning of greenhorn here? Someone who is inexperienced. So, this word suits here. The person who is inexperienced joined the softball team needs a lot of practice. So, the greenhorn, you are filling the word from the box, the greenhorn. The greenhorn who joined the softball team needs a lot of practice. And my sister's marriage was dash. My sister's marriage was dash. What's the meaning here? A bolt from the blue and unexpected happening. So my sister's marriage was an unexpected happening. The greenhorn who joined the softball team needs a lot of practice. My sister's marriage was a bowl from the blue. So when you get in your exams, you will be given some phrases in the box. You need to see the phrases. Just find out the meaning for all those phrases. And see the sentences given below. And fill in the sentences using the right phrases that is given in your question paper. So for homophones, you need to see the words given in the box. And see which word will be suitable for the sentence given in the question paper. And according to the questions, you need to fill the answers. And for phrases also, first get to know the meaning. Just try to find out the meanings for the phrases given. And then fill it in the blanks given in your question paper. Okay, children, we will move on to the next part, that is singular and plural. Let's see the definition of singular and plural first. See what singular? It refers to only one person, place or a thing. It refers to only one person, place or thing. So whatever it is, it refers to only one. For example, boy, girl, book, chair, whatever it is, only one without any plural forms. So the next one, plural. It refers to more than one person, place or thing. It refers to more than one person, place or thing. It may be two, three, whatever, more than one. It is called as plural. For example, see, in singular we will say boy, here we will say boys, girl, girls, book, books. Boy, boys, girl, girls, book in plural, books. So singular it refers to only one person, place or thing. Plural it refers to more than one person, place or thing. And there are two kinds of verbs like this. One is regular and other is irregular. What's regular? Regular, what do we do with regular verbs? We do add just s or es with the verbs given. We do add this s or es with the verbs given. So in irregular, we do change the word itself. We do change the spelling of the word itself. And in the same regular, we do say both boats. When in plural, we do add s with this. So we do say boats. And in bus, we do add es. We say this buses. So we add s or es. Boats, buses. And here in irregular, we change the spelling itself. What's the plural form? Child, children. So the spelling itself differs. Child, children. Person, people. Likewise, you can check. And when let's see some examples here. Write the plural forms of these nouns given below. The first one is street. We add s with it. So street, streets. Class. We add es with class. So class, classes. Table, tables. Church, churches. Fly, flies. Fly, flies. And when the word ends with y, we take off y and we add ies. Fly, flies. Leave, leave. See here, y, we do take off y and we add ies here. When the add ends with f, we do take off this f and we add bes. So fly, flies. Leave, leaves. F we take out and we add bes with the word leaves, leaves. Here person, people. Person, people. Street, streets. Class, classes. Table, tables. Church, churches. Fly, flies. Leave, leaves. Person, people. Shall we do an exercise? Yes, come on. Write the plural forms of the words given in brackets to complete each sentence. So, in your exam, you will be given as sentences. Not just the words, you will be given as sentences. You need to find out the word which is given in the bracket and change the word given in the bracket to plural form. Do you understand? What you have to do? You have to see the word which is given in the bracket and the bracket word you need to change it into plural form. So, the first one. Cats like to catch dash. The word given here is mouse. What's the plural form of mouse? Mice. So cats like to catch mice. The next word. How many dash are there in the school yard? Child. The word given here is child. What's the plural form of child? Children. So how many children are there in the school yard? Next one. Sneha drew many dash in the book. Sneha drew many dash in the book. Bracket word is picture. So we add s with it. Sneha drew many pictures in the book. Next one. I saw two dash on the road. I saw two dash on the road. Word given here is bus. We add s with it, es with it. So the answer is buses. I saw two buses on the road. Next one. I wanted to visit my dash. Word is cousin. The given word is cousin. So when you change it into plural, it is cousins. I wanted to visit my cousins. Cats like to catch mice. How many children are there in the school yard? Sneha drew many pictures in the book. I saw two buses on the road. I wanted to visit my cousins. Hope you all understood what singular and plural. We'll move on with our next topic. We are now in present tense and past tense. As we have seen last year itself in present tense and past tense, we are now just seeing a few examples. Before that, I'll explain you only the rules. So, when it is given in present tense, if it is and am, you need to change it to was. So, is and am will be changed to was when it comes to past. And are will be changed to were. Have or has is given in the sentence. Present sentence, you will be changing it into had. And be1 verb will be changed to be2 verb, which means verb or verb with s or verb with es will be changed to verb with ed or it will be changed to be to form. If in the present tense if we have do or does verbs, you will change it into did. So is and am will be changed to was or were. Have and has will be changed to had. B1 to B2, which means B1 means verb or verb with s or verb with es. So B2 means verb with ed or the verb will be changed to B2 form. Do or does will be changed to did. So let's have some exercise question answers. Like this one, you will have for exam, not the exact. We will have our own. This is just for example. So the first one, he called desperately for help. So the question will be, fill in the blanks using the correct words given in the brackets. So he called desperately for help. Here it will be given in past tense. So the sentences are given in past tense. You need to change the sentences to present form. So these type of words will be given. You need to change it into normal present form. He called desperately for help. The verb here is call. Verb is given with ed. Verb plus ed. So we do change it to verb or verb plus s or verb plus es. Since it is given he, we do change calls. He calls desperately for help. He calls desperately for help. The next one, we suggested to write the exam. The answer is we suggest. We will take out ed and we write suggest only. Since it is we, since it is plural form, we write only the verb here. We suggest her to write the exam. Next one, I heard this song frequently. I heard this song frequently. So I hear this song frequently. The present form of the past word heard is here. The present form of heard is here. I hear this song frequently. The next one, the children were informed. See here, where, if it is given there, what will be the present form? Are. So the children are informed. The next one, the kite flew gaily into the air. The verb given here is flew. The past verb given here is flew. What is the present form of this fly? So since it is the kite. So we write flies, verb with es. The kite flies gaily into the air. The kite flew gaily into the air. We change this flew. The present form of flew is flies. Fly and we add es since it is the kite. The kite flies gaily into the air. Hope you all understood this. Just see the verb which is given in an underlined form and change the verb. That is, change the past verb to the present verb and write the sentence as it is. So here what is given here is present tense and past tense. And the next grammar part we do have is conjunctions. Conjunctions using so and that. How do we combine two sentences? There will be two sentences. You need to combine these two sentences as one. See the first one. See the rules first using so and that. See the first one. Meena was sick. This is one sentence. Meena was sick. And the next sentence, she couldn't go to school. Meena was sick. She couldn't go to school. Now we are combining these two sentences. We have seen it elaborately in our last video. Just see this one example. Meena was after the verb. After the be verb, you write so here. Meena was so sick. And you take out this full stop and write here. Connecting word for joining these two sentences is that. So after the be verb, you write so. And this full stop you take out and write that here. The connecting word that here. And the next sentence, as it is given in the question, she couldn't go to school. The change is here you will start with capital. In the question it is given in capital. When you write as a continuous sentence, you will change this s's small. That's all. Nothing more to change here. Meena was so sick. You will write this so after the be verb and add that instead of the full stop and write the sentence, next sentence as it is. So many of you are writing, Meena was sick so that she couldn't go to school. That is wrong and you need to follow the same rules that is given here. See the next one. Ritik was tired. He went to bed early. Ritik was tired. he went to bed early. Ritik was after the beaver. Beaver is was here. After the beaver, we are adding so. So Ritik was so tired. And instead of this wisdom, we'll take out this wisdom and write that here. And we are changing this capital H into small h. Ritik was so tired that he went to bed early. That's all. And Rani Padmini was clever. She outwitted the enemy. Rani Padmini, after the beaver was, we are writing so here. Rani Padmini was so clever that she outwitted the enemy. We are changing this capital S to small s. There will be no full stop when till you complete this sentence. When you write the answer, there will be no full stop till you complete the sentence. Next one, Jenny worked hard. She could pass her exams. Jenny worked hard. She could pass her exams. See the answer. Jenny worked. After this verb, we add so here. So Jenny worked so hard, and we are taking out this full stop and add that here, that she could pass her exams. Jenny worked hard. She could pass her exams. Jenny worked so hard that she could pass her exams. So if you write so that continuously, it is a wrong form. You need to follow the rule that is given here. So you need to be thorough with conjunctions so that you can attend your exam properly. Okay children, we will move on to our next topic. So far we have seen reading comprehension, how to read the passage and answer the questions that follows, and all the subtopics that are given in grammar, that are homophones, singular and plural phrases, conjunctions using so and that, combining two sentences using so and that, and also present tense and past tense, how to change the sentence that is given in past tense to present tense. So now we move on to literature part. What are given in literature part for us? Synonyms, antonyms, and the question answers. First we will revise synonyms. So from both the chapters, that is from blessed, respectable, and a great heroine, I have written all the synonyms in this. And you must have got your glossaries in your class or not. You can go through all those. Just we will revise this. First one, wealth. Wealth means state of being rich. The next one, limb. Limb means an arm or leg of a person. Madden, insane. Sight, ability to see. Scent, a pleasant smell. It is a pleasant smell, not smile. A pleasant smell. S-M-E-L-L. Late see shoe, meaning of attack. Blank hearted, with arms, weapons. Fight, quarrel. Harm, damage or injury. So the first one, wealth, state of being rich, limb, an arm or leg of a person. Madden, insane. Sight, ability to see. Scent, a pleasant smell. Late see shoe, attack. Black hearted, wicked. Arms, weapons. Fight, quarrel. Harm, damage or injury. You must have written all these synonyms in your class alone. I want you to go through all those. And next we will move to antonyms. Antonyms, what are the antonyms given here? Brave, fearful. What's the antonym for brave? Which means opposites. Brave, opposite is fearful. F-E-A-R-F-U-L. Trust, distrust. Surprise, predictable. Return, depart. Later, earlier. Brave, fearful, trust, distrust, surprise, predictable, return, depart, later, earlier. Okay, so you must be very thorough with synonyms, antonyms given in a class work note, and go through the book back pages also, and the glossary is given in your class work note. So accuracy is only question and answers. Identify the question answers in your in the board, or just we will revise using the note. Revise with me, take your note and revise with me. So from the poem Blessed Is My Work, we have few questions. What's the first question? Why does the poet think that his birth is blessed? Why does the poet think that his birth is blessed? Answer me. The poet thinks that his birth is blessed because he was born in this country. And the next question, who's the mother mentioned in the second line of the poem? In the poem, in the second line of the poem, you might have got the word mother. What is the word mother mentioned? So mother mentioned here, which means in the poem, mother mentioned here is the country where the poet born and has lived in. Next one, pick out an example of alliteration from the poem. So from the poem we have got rhyme scheme, that is an alliteration. So blessed is my birth because I was born. All B will be there. Blessed is my birth because I was born in. That is the alliteration line from the poem. What is the guilt that the poet feels in his mother's shade? The guilt that the poet feels in his mother's shade is his ability to cool his limbs. The guilt that the poet feels in his mother's shade is its ability to cool his limbs. The next question, what are the aspects of nature that delight the poet? What are the aspects of nature that delight the poet? The answer is sweet smells of blooming flowers. So the first one is sweet smells of blooming flowers. The next one, smiles of the sun. So sweet smells of blooming flowers and the smiles of the sun when it rises are the aspects of the that delight the poet. Then when you come to who's the poet of the poem? Blessed is my birth. Rabindranath Tagore is the poet of the poem. Blessed is my birth. And what's he celebrating in this poem? Yes, the poet is celebrating his love for his motherland in this poem. And what's the light he is talking of in the poem? He is talking about the light that comes from the sun. And what are the events in a person's life are being referred in this poem, Blessed is my birth? The events are the birth and death. First open, the birth first open refers to the birth of a person, and the birth closed finally refers to the death of a person. Got it? So far we have seen Blessed is my birth question answers. Next we'll move to a great heroine question answers. Synonyms and antonyms from both the chapters are written here. Answer from a great heroine. First question, how many years ago did Alauddin rule Delhi? What's the answer? Alauddin ruled Delhi about 700 years ago. How many years ago? About 700 years ago. Next question, what was the capital of Mewar at that time? Chittoor was the capital of Mewar at that time. So try to frame answers from the questions itself. Chittoor was the capital of Mewar at that time. Next one, who was the Rajput Raja of the capital of Mewar? Who was the Rajput Raja? Of course, Ratan Singha, also known as Binsi. Ratan Singha, also known as Binsi, was the Rajput Raja of the capital of Mewar. Next one, who was Padmini here? Yes, the Padmini was the queen here. Rani Padmini was the queen of Chittoor. The place is Chittoor. Padmini was the queen here. The brave and beautiful wife of Ratan Singha. Who is she? She was the wife of Ratan Singha, also known as Binsi. Next one, how did Alauddin see the face of Padmini? How was he allowed to see? He was allowed to see only through the mirror, right? Do you all remember? Yes, the answer is Alauddin saw the reflection, just the reflection, not the face directly. Alauddin saw the reflection of Padmini's face in the mirror. Next one, who travelled in the palanquin instead of Rani Padmini? Who travelled in the palanquin? Everyone thought that Rani Padmini is inside the palanquin, right? But Rani Padmini was not inside. What happened here? A Rajput boy named Badal. What's the name? Badal. A Rajput boy named Badal was inside instead of Rani Padmini. The next one, what was the name of Rani Padmini's uncle? There was a name for Rani Padmini's uncle. Yes. Gora was the name of Rani Padmini's uncle. G-O-R-A-H. Gora was the name of Rani Padmini's uncle. And next question. Who is the speaker of these lines? As the Turks, just listen the lines. As the Turks have no honor and has deceived us, we must pay them back in their own coin. These lines are spoken by Rani Padmini, the queen of Chittoor. And how did they feel that the Turks deceived them? Yes, the Turks deceived them by imprisoning the king of Chittoor, which means Vimsi. Yes, the Turks deceived them by imprisoning the king of Chittoor. After showing interest in parting as friends, he called Alauddin called Vimsi to come out to become friends, but he took him from there only. So the Turks deceived them by imprisoning the king of Chittoor after showing interest in parting as friends. Next question: did the Turks give up easily? Do you think? No, the Turks did not give up easily. There was a great battle between the Rajputs and the Turks in which many people were killed. So the Turks did not give up easily. There was a great battle between the Turks and the Rajputs in which many people were killed. And how did the listen these lines? What am I going to say? As I have trusted you, do you know? Trust me. As I have trusted you, do you not trust me? Come with me outside the fort and let's part as friends. So these lines are spoken by whom? Yes, Alauddin. Alauddin said these lines to Vimsi. Asked him to come out by these lines. So the speaker is Alauddin Khilji and he was speaking to Ratan Simha, also known as Vimsi. How did the speaker show his trust in the person he was speaking to? So Alauddin spoken to Vimsi. So how did Vimsi believed it? How did Vimsi believe it? Because the speaker showed his interest in the person he was speaking to by going with them inside the fort with only two guards. Because Alauddin made Vimsi believe that he came with only two guards. Because inside the fort he was with only two guards. So he made Vimsi believe that he came with only two guards. By this, he made him to come out. Next one, describe the plan Padmini made to rescue her husband. It comes in later answer. Describe the plan. There was a plan made by Padmini to rescue her husband from Alauddin Khilji. So what is the plan that she made? Rani Padmini wanted herself to be allowed to bring all her women servants, jewels and clothes in closed palanquins without being instructed by the Turks. She doesn't want anyone to inspect the palanquin that she is coming. Alauddin Khilji happily agreed because he thought that all the women servants, jewels, everything comes to him. But she sent a brave Rajput boy named Badal. Who was inside the palanquin? There was a brave Rajput boy named Badal instead of her, and one Rajput boy soldier in each of the other 70 palanquins. There were 70 palanquins. In other 70 palanquins, there were one Rajput boy. They are actually soldiers. Each palanquin was carried by 6 men. How many men? 6 men who looked like coolies, but they were in fact the brave soldiers who had with them swords and shields. This was Padmini's plan to rescue her husband. So what's the second question? What tricks did Alauddin Khilji play upon Vimsi? The answer is, Alauddin Khilji told Vimsi that all he wanted was a glimpse of Padmini. He promised to take his troops back to Delhi if his request was granted. After having looked at Padmini in the mirror, he invited Vimsi with them outside the fort so that they could part as friends. But when Vimsi came out of the fort, he made his soldiers seize Vimsi and take him to prison. This is the trick Khilji played upon Vimsi. So what he did? Alauddin Khilji told to Vimsi that all he wanted was just the glimpse of Rani Padmini. So he promised to take his troops back to Delhi if his request was granted. And after having looked at Padmini, what he did? He called Vimsi outside the fort, then only they can part as friends. So by believing these words, Vimsi also came out. And when Vimsi came out, he made his soldiers, Alauddin Khilji's soldiers. So he made his soldiers seize Vimsi and take him to prison. This is the trick Alauddin Khilji played upon Vimsi. Okay children, we have covered all the questions. Hope you must have written all the classwork in all the question answers in your classwork note. And be thorough, learn properly for your exams. Be thorough for the examination. and there are few rules and regulations that you need to follow when writing your unit test. So the instructions to be followed is you need to use only rule sheets. So you need to use only rule sheets and use black and blue ink pen. Okay, sorry, this is written in black, and use blue ink pen. For writing your answers, you will use blue ink pen and draw finishing lines for each and every question. Draw finishing lines. Draw single lines, not double lines. And date, subject, and the test that you are going to write. Unit test one. And the date on the particular day that you are writing. And the subject is English. And question numbers must be the same as it is given in your question paper, not your own question and question numbers. And presentation should be very neat, right? Very neatly and clearly. Use scale and pencil to draw lines. Just don't scribble in your answer sheet. Attempt every question. Try to attempt all the questions that is given in the question paper. And avoid overwriting. Just don't overwrite. If you have written it wrong, just give a small strike and write near the word. And don't use whitener. Avoid whitener. Please don't use whitener. Either strike off the word and write after the word. Okay. Hope you will follow all the instructions. We expect everyone to attend your unit test one. You will be seeing the revision video. Go through all the videos and get to clear your doubts. And all the best for your exam, children. We hope that you will all do well. Thank you.